Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please put your hands together to welcome on stage Mr. Simerjeet Singh.
Good morning. When I was in grade 10 plus 1, right? You are in 10 plus 1? 10 plus 2? 10 plus 2. So I was in 10 plus 1, 10 plus 2. I used to study in a college called Bearing Union Christian College, Batala. Anyone familiar with BUC, Bearing Union Christian College, Batala? I was a student there. So I was a commerce student. Where are the commerce students? Raise your hands. Yes, you can all rejoice. I had a gentleman who was a CA. He came from Amritsar. He was a CA and, you know, he came in his Maruti 1000 was a car that had just been launched. So he came in his nice flashy car, you know, and he carried himself very well. And I looked at him and I could see my future, you know, some part of my future. I was like, wow, this is good, yeah. So when my reason of coming here to schools, I work with, you know, large corporations, I work with non-profit organizations, I work with government organizations in this country and across the world. But my purpose of coming to schools is this. Hopefully you can get the information that we did not get. Hopefully you can get the guidance that we did not get. Hopefully your doubts can be removed with which lingered on in our mind. That is the entire intention. And the second intention behind video is this. To take this information to millions of young children across the country. The future of any country depends upon its youth, yes or no? Are they fired up or are they bored? Are they bored most of the time? Are they busy playing PUBG or are they thinking about their future? Do they see a vision ahead? Unko ye lagta hai ki nahi, nothing's gonna happen with my future. What do they see? The future of a nation depends upon its youngsters. In India, we have the privilege right now of being the youngest country in the world. All the other countries are graying, you know, populations. China had this one child policy. You're aware of that? Yes? And due to that, their population now is more towards the senior citizens. India, by the year 2030, is going to be one of the youngest countries in the world. We have a huge advantage, yes or no? Advantage or disadvantage? It could be both, right? And that depends upon you, what you do with your life. If you do something valuable, you're going to make a huge difference. But if you lose out on this opportunity, it's all wasted. It's a wasted opportunity, right? So we did a similar program at GNA University some time back. And those were slightly senior students. They were in their post-graduation. And we did a similar program. And counting roughly, I think we have 10 million views for that program, right? So, one single video was, how can I improve my communication skills? What was it? Improve my communication skills. That has crossed 5 million views altogether. But these are the two things. I want to change your moods. It's really important. Do you understand this? Some of you had posed questions, how can I improve my learning process? Your mind is the most powerful tool ever. If you're scared, if you are not breathing properly, if you're not comfortable, you can never learn any single thing. And the sad part in the Indian education system is, so many students spend their entire career sitting in classrooms where they are scared, where they are uncomfortable, and then they wonder, mujhe kuch samajh nahi aaya. If this was closed, how are you going to understand, right? So here's what I want you to do. Just be comfortable. We are friends here, okay? We're going to have a friendly conversation. Is that a deal? Yes? And I have worked very hard on this today. I've worked very hard on this and I will give you my 100%. That's my promise. Question is, will you? Some of you are not sure. Some of you are checking with the person sitting next to me. Theek hai, kar le. Will you give me your 100%? Yes or no? Is that a promise?
Yes, sir.
Shall we get started?
Yes, sir.
This sounds like the MGN school I've heard about. Give yourselves a round of applause and take your deep breaths in and we'll get started. Did you know it's somebody's birthday today? Not someone, that would be. Anyone's birthday in this room, by the way, today? Huh? It's a very important entity's birthday today. It's one of the most vital things in your life. It's the birthday today. That thing. What do human beings need to survive? Come on. Basic human needs. Oxygen, food, water. One more. I'm giving you a hint now. It's someone's birthday today. It may or may not be human. I'm giving you a hint. But it's top human need. PUBG. So Modi ji bole, ye PUBG wala hai kya? No, not PUBG. PUBG is only like a few months old. It's a little infant. It's already a rage all across the country. People are bumping into each other. They do. In Jalandhar recently, a guy stole 50,000 rupees from his father's bank account, huh? Yes, it's the internet's birthday. It is, for those of you who read the newspaper, the internet has turned 30-year-old today, right? Is basic human need, yes or no? Once again, I thank the authorities, Principal Sir, Vice Principal Ma'am, I believe was sitting here, and Rohani Ma'am for all her consistent follow-ups, so many emails going back and forth, and Gitanjali, of course, and Kunal and his team for being here today. Give them, please, a big round of applause for organizing today. How do you define intelligence? Let's get started with this. Who is intelligent? Don't look at each other. Anyone whose confidence is intelligent? Rab bachaye mere desh ne. The only parameter of intelligence is confidence. Wow. Okay, but thank you for answering. Thank you. I give you that. But it would appear to be that way. It would seem to be that way. But it may not be true. And especially at your age, we had a question about peer pressure. We will talk about that too. Sometimes the biggest idiots are the most confident people. And sometimes the most smartest, intelligent individuals are full of doubts. So be very careful. Next, who is intelligent? How do you define intelligence? Come on. Knowledge, okay? Knowledge is free these days, yes or no? In our smartphones. So which means everybody is intelligent? Come on, who's intelligent? Responding to situations, that's a good one. Adapting to situations, different responses. More, how do you define intelligence? An intelligent person, I'm going to use English and a little bit of Hindi for the sake of our YouTube audience also and for you as well. Otherwise, I'm a big supporter in Punjab. We should speak Punjabi. But because our audience is for the YouTube is spread all across the nation, so for the sake of our YouTube audience also, we'll keep it in here largely in English and some parts in Hindi, okay? But let's get started. Who is intelligent? So let me give you a few examples. Would you consider Sachin Tendulkar intelligent? Raise your hands, please, if you believe he's intelligent. Oh my God! Sachin will not be happy to see this. Now all of you are raising your hands just to support the god of cricket. Okay, be honest. How many of you would consider Mr. Amitabh Bachchan intelligent? Sir, he's confident. Therefore, he's intelligent. Okay. How many of you would consider A.R. Rahman intelligent? Now your teamwork is happening. A.R. Rahman, yaar, my favorite musician. Haath khada karo. Okay, how many of you would consider, have you heard of Dr. Naresh Trehan, the country's leading cardiologist? Right, he's the country's leading heart surgeon. You don't want to be on his table. But how many of you would consider a cardiologist to be very intelligent? Of course, without a doubt. Dr. Hai intelligent hoga. Okay. We'll get to this. Now take a deep breath in and pat yourself on the back. Pat yourself on the shoulders and with self-belief and pride say, I am intelligent. Kuch log bol rahe, sir, itna bada jhoot main bol raha. All right, pat the person sitting next to you on their back and tell them, you are intelligent. Say it now. Yes. Bas ek hi baar pat karna tha. Some of you like, all right. We'll get into this. I believe every human being is intelligent in his or her own way. Mr. Bachchan is intelligent, so is Sachin Tendulkar. Knowing it is called spatial intelligence. Knowing to understand what speed the ball is going to come, to what angle to hit it on, and to maintain his ethics after being a celebrity. Though that is intelligence, right? So many other things. So that answer was very, very good in the back, which I heard. The ability to respond to different environments in different ways is intelligence. In a way, that is a very nice definition of intelligence. Intelligence is not linear. Do you know the meaning of linear? Linear means in a straight line. So intelligence is not something which is in a straight line. Intelligence could be actually the great. Now we're living in an era where creativity is going to be the number one skill. What is it? Creativity and innovation is the number one skill required to succeed in the future. And creativity never goes in a straight line. Agree, disagree? There is no songwriter who sat down one morning, say, I'll sit down for the next half an hour and I'll finish my song. It doesn't happen that way. It's non-linear. What is it?
Do you get the difference between this? Now, studies, academics tend to be linear. You know, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, so on and so forth, right? But creativity and innovation, they are non-linear things, and you have to understand that for me to also appreciate, if I'm operating in a non-linear way, if my brain is operating in a non-linear way, what will happen is maybe the academic system will not reward you as much. But that does not mean you are stupid. That does not mean you are not intelligent. That does not mean your IQ is less than anyone. You see, has anyone seen assembly line manufacturing system? Where a car is assembled, every single product turns out to be the same, yes or no? The same nut goes in the same place. Everything is driven by precision. I was in Gurgaon at the Maruti Suzuki factory, and it was a marvel to see how the cars are all put together, right? Every single car is going to be the same if it's of the same brand. Does it work the same with human beings, yes or no? Some of you are not sure. Is there someone on this planet who is exactly like you? The same DNA, same fingerprints, but more importantly, same thinking. Now, since your thinking is different, even identical twins are thinking differently. Since your thinking is different, that makes you what? Some of you are not sure about this. That makes you unique. You were born to be unique. Once again, take a deep breath in. Shout out loud. I was born to be unique. Say it out, please. I was born to be unique. I was born to be me.
I was born to be me.
Not somebody else's copy. You were not born to be somebody else's copy. You were born to be yourself. And I'm going to show you a little roadmap, a little process in which you can be yourself. Would that be useful? So you can be you, so you can identify what are my unique talents. I don't have to fit in into something. Mujhe kis us cheez mein nahi dhalna hai that society expects from me. I have to be myself. Discover what my strengths are. Now, imagine Tendulkar would have been forced to become a dentist. Think about that. He would have walked into a room with his bat in his hand. Dikhao kaun sa... Right? This is a person's strengths. And when you capitalize on your strengths, when you do what? Capitalize on your strengths, you are able to do far more in your life. And this is not something you will discover in these 2 hours. Please remember this. Don't expect this. I will finish the session and suddenly I will know what am I good at. It's a lifelong process of self-discovery. Who am I? What am I good at? In fact, we'll do a small exercise, and most of you, and I can assure you this, most of you will know more about your smartphones than you will about yourself. If I ask you, give me 10 features of your smartphones, you will all be able to tell me without a doubt. If I ask you, give me 10 unique qualities about yourself, you will all be struggling working with audiences like yourself. First is that you're an intelligent audience. I will learn something from you. In fact, I have learned so much from young audiences in the past. Some of these words were not in my dictionary. I used to actually laugh, and then I was introduced to LOL. Right? And I found LOL is a much better version than laugh. And then I was introduced to the plural of LOL, which was LOLs. This is all these young guys and girls, you're coming up with all this new dictionary. And then I came up with the next version of it, which is ROFL. You don't know this one? You're getting there. You're getting there. You'll get there. This is rolling on the floor laughing. So this generation is not actually laughing. They're putting all these terminologies out there, right? And this is one of the reasons I've come here, hoping to learn a little bit something from you as well. Then we have this this new one. Even I don't know this one. I was hoping you could tell me. You can look up on your phone later on and tell us what it is, right? Since you're carrying it, you can make some... This is very popular. BRB, be right back. Yeah? So you're cutting... You want everything short and sweet and, you know, condensed into something, and you're expecting life works that way. Oh, there's OMG. The thing is, now it's moved from your mobile phones into your actual vocabulary, yes or no? Earlier, people used to type on the phone, not people, youngsters used to type on the phones, OMG, and now they actually say to each other, oh bro, OMG. Like, wow, which is this new? TTYL. The first time I came across, I was like, what is this? And I figured out it is a shorter version of talk to you later, right? This is all. TIA. I get this in emails now. When this generation is going into the corporate India and they're writing emails, they write TIA. Trans International Atlantic Airlines? No. Thanks in advance. It's TIA. And
by the way, right? So these are the advantages of working with an intelligent audience such as yourself. Don't underestimate yourself. You are very, very intelligent. You even teach people like me, you know, and that's why it's a pleasure being here among youngsters.